name's Snape, a local councillor. Cleaning staff went into his room, found the suicide note on his bed.
The window was open. They looked out
and saw the body down here.
Do you think it's got anything to do with the corruption allegations that have been in the papers?
Excuse me. Any chance of a statement?
Our friends in the press seem to think so. Would you please stop taking pictures? Show a little respect. So...
Yeah, thanks for your What are you playing at? OK, is there anything else I should know?
Only this. It's written on hotel writing paper.
Dear Sarah, please forgive me. I'm really sorry, all my love, Tony. Do we know what he's sorry about?
He lives locally and he's staying in a hotel.
So she's chucked him out?
I had a quick look in his address book. Looks like the same handwriting.
Have you found what you're looking for?
Yeah, I'd like to get a tester of that, please.
Certainly. How am I going to tell whether they're going to suit me? I mean, like, I'm really going to wear them like this. Couldn't you put the label on the side bit so I could stick it behind my ear?
She's got a point. Is anyone from security nearby? Excuse me, I'm a DC Glaze from Sunhill. There's a young lady over there who got some sunglasses in her bag she hasn't paid for. That's her there.
The bike, please.
What's going on?
May I see the contents of your bag, please?
Why? Oi!
You have a receipt for these?
You just planted those in there. I've never seen them before in my life.
You just took these items from the accessories counter.
Oh, I get it. What's your next line? You'll drop the charges if I show you my gratitude. That's disgusting.
Have you finished?
No, I have not. I've a good mind to make a complaint.
Uh-huh. Well, maybe you'd like to make it to this gentleman here. This is the man who saw you take the items and place them in your handbag. Meet Detective Constable Glaze.
On being asked to show a receipt for the goods in her possession, she was unable to do so. The store wants to press charges.
What have you got to say for yourself, Jessie?
How was I supposed to know there was a copper at the perfume counter?
This is serious, Jessie.
Tell you what if I had some serious information to trade? About vice and corrupt councillors and suicides, what would you say then?
I'd say we don't do deals.
Right. I want to make my phone call.
Can I have a word? Kerry Holmes has just been to a suspicious death. One councillor, Anthony Snape.
So it looks like he threw himself out the window and landed in the skip.
Very thoughtful of him.
Nice to know when a councillor finally knows his place, eh?
You think he's connected to the vice and corruption allegations?
Well, the press seem to think it is, so probably not, then.
I've got a young shoplifter downstairs, so she knows something about it.
Is she genuine?
Might be worth checking out.
I don't know. These corruption rumours have been around for a while. What do you reckon, Gov?
Well, it's a bit of a coincidence. All right, yeah, talk to her. But if nothing's forthcoming, drop it. I mean, I like the idea of doing these bank councillors as much as anyone, but I'm sure you've got enough stuff to be going on with.
Gov.
Make her feel important, but explain that the store always prosecutes. No, just play up how helpful we're going to tell the courts you've been. You know, the usual.
Right. Thanks for the tips, Danny.
The store's dropped the charges.
The security manager's just phoned through. I couldn't get hold of you.
See how easy it is?
Just sign there, please.
It's time for me to go?
Yeah, just ease off on the freelance shopping. You might not be so fortunate next time.
Nice meeting you, Detective Constable Glaze.
What about that matter we discussed?
You should have taken me up on it when you had the chance.
Well, look. If you want to talk to me about it, give me a call. What the hell is going on?
Mr. Brownlow phoned down to find out about Jess's situation.
What does he know about it?
Well, it turns out that her stepfather is Councillor Colin Cooper. And he's in the same Masonic Lodge as Mr. Brownlow. Anyway, I told him that it was the store's policy always to prosecute, and he seemed to accept that. And then a couple of minutes after Mr. Brownlow puts the phone down, the security manager rings me. Says that they've decided to drop the charges. his ex-job. My guess is he's on the square as well.
You what?
Well, we probably wouldn't have got anything anyway.
Hang on, hang on. Do you know what this Councillor Cooper's responsibilities are at County Council?
No idea.
White middle-class elite closing ranks. Unbelievable.
Excuse me?
Well, what would you call it? You heard who a stepdad is. She might well have had some good information.
Yeah, and she might just be another kid who wants to cause trouble for a stepdad. Well, hey, maybe she's got a huge chip on her shoulder too.
Health and Safety Committee. Thank you. Colin Cooper's on the Health and Safety Committee, as was Councillor Snape. The same Health and Safety Committee that decides which massage parlours get licensed. Interesting, too, that Mr. Brownlow decides which licence applications to support.
You want to be very careful about what you're implying here, Danny.
I think I'd like to talk to Snape's widow. Interested?
Ooh, can't wait.
I just wanted time on my own. I never dreamt it. I didn't say it was permanent. I never said that.
Can I ask why you wanted the separation?
He had been seeing someone else, and, well, I just couldn't cope. That was all.
Who was he seeing?
He didn't say. Just said she was, unimportant. Why did he do it?
I think there might be another reason.
That's what the journalist asked me.
What journalist?
He was here a minute ago before you arrived. He showed me a picture and asked if I knew anyone in it.
And did you?
It was a charity do, a children's hospice appeal. Yes, there were two people I recognised with my husband, Tony. Colin Cooper and a man. I couldn't remember his first name. A Mr. Trent.
Stephen Trent?
That's it. He seemed very interested in him. Made out he was a bit dodgy. But he couldn't have been. I mean, even your Mr. Brownlow was chatting away with him.
Chief Superintendent Brownlow? He was at the same function?
Yes. Hang on a second. Here we are.
Thank you.
I remember Stephen Trent came and sat down at the table later on in the evening. Had a long chat with Mr. Brownlow.
Is this the photograph that the journalist showed you?
No. No, Mr. Brownlow wasn't in the other one.
Did you show this one to the journalist?
No.
Can we borrow it?
Yes.
So, old Mr. Brownlow's best mates with the councillors. Interesting.
Well, what do you expect? They serve on all those committees together.
What about this Stephen Trent? Who's he?
He owns a string of massage parlours.
Why doesn't that surprise me?
Martin French. Nice to meet you again.
Hi, I'm DC Holmes. This is DC Glaze.
Hi.
Can I have a look at that photo that you just showed Mrs. Snape? Thank you. Stephen Trent's the one in the middle.
And the other two are Cooper and Snape.
Right. So what's your interest here?
Council corruption.
Go on.
Anonymous tip-off, vice, massage parlours, that sort of thing.
What evidence have you got?
Well, I'll show you mine if you show me yours.
I think we'll pass, thanks. Well, it stinks. You've got to admit it. Too many coincidences. I want to talk to Jessie. She knows something. She has to.
I'll get him. Can I help you?
Will you turn that music down? Now!
I'm DC Glaze. This is DC Holmes. Is Jessie at home?
What's it about?
We'd like to talk to her.
I'll ask you again, why do you want to talk to my daughter?
Stepdaughter!
Get back inside.
I'm 18. I can do what I like. And if DC Glaze wants to talk to me, that's fine. As long as he buys me a drink. The pub's just round the corner. creep. I don't know how my mum puts up with him.
What we talked about earlier, Jessie, the corruption at the council.
Thought you'd be interested.
Does your stepfather have anything to do with it?
Are you kidding? He's the godfather.
Thank you. Here you go.
Cheers.
So, what can you tell us?
Bryony, how you doing? I'm just doing a bit of business. Catch you later.
Right.
Take care.
Bryony Glover. Not exactly the best sort of company, is she? She's a smack addict.
Yeah, well, she's trying to kick it. She's all right. She's always been a good friend to me.
No one's perfect. So, what can you tell us about your stepdad, Jessie?
He's a bastard. It's people like him drove that councillor to suicide. They're all the same.
What exactly do you mean by that?
Creepy masons. Your Mr. Brownlow's just as bad. You know he makes sure the massage parlours don't get raided. Oh, no.
Home. Now. Come on, I'm not having you telling any of your lies, causing trouble.
I don't tell lies.
Not much you don't. Come on.
Excuse me, are you Mrs. Cooper?
That's right, and I'm her mother. And I want her home now.
We just want to ask her a few questions.
Forget it. Come on.
I'm sorry.
Well, I'd take that with a large pinch of salt if I were you.
What, and forget we heard it, just like that?
Just take it easy, Danny.
Kerry, it stinks, and you know it does, with everything else we've heard. I want to talk to this Stephen Trent. So, where can we find him?
He likes his charity dues, doesn't he?
Just a bit. Look at that suit. It's with a platinum CD.
Bought it at one of the charity auctions. Won't cheap either. But he's a favourite artist. And you've got to help the little kiddies, haven't you?
Come on.
Thank you.
Please, take a seat. Make yourself comfortable. Tell me, what can I do for you?
I'll get straight to the point, Mr. Trent. There was a possible suicide today. Councillor Snape?
Yes, I heard about that. Tragedy. Tragedy.
We're trying to establish why he did it. We're asking people who knew him if they have any ideas.
I think there's been some sort of misunderstanding. I didn't know Mr. Snape. Certainly not well. An acquaintance, but nothing more. I certainly wouldn't know anything about his private life.
We're not sure his death was to do with his private life. There are rumours of a corruption scandal.
Really?
He was on the Health and Safety Committee, which decided, for instance, to license premises like your string of massage parlours.
I'm aware of that. But as I say, we didn't mix socially. Constable Glaze, I run a highly respectable chain of health clubs and massage suites. I hope you're not suggesting anything different.
They've never been raided.
Well, I'd like to think our local police have better things to do with their time. I'm sorry, I can't be any more help.
May I? Sure, I've met Smarmy Gits. Just don't remember when.
Don't let them get to you.
All those charity dues, a very cost-effective way of laundering your reputation. They're all at it. Dodgy bankers, iffy lawyers, arms dealers, flushing the cash for good causes in as public a way as possible so their wives feel better about where all their designer frocks and flashy cars comes from. Makes me sick.
Now just don't beat around the bush, Danny. Just tell me what you really think.
Kerry, Danny. Got a moment, please. Shut the door.
I understand you went round to see Jessie Cooper earlier.
Yes, sir.
Her stepfather wants to know why you want to question her again when the shoplifting charge has been dropped.
I think she's got information that may be useful to us, sir.
Oh? What kind of information?
regarding council corruption.
Is that what she told you? Well, I'm surprised you've been taken in by her, Danny. She's a troublemaker. She resents the fact that Colin married her mother. She's trying to split them up. That's why she's made the allegations to embarrass him for the council. That explains the shoplifting, the drug taking. She's a menace. Apparently, after you went round, there was a family row. Jessie's left home, gone to stay with some extremely undesirable friends, heroin addicts. So perhaps you could think a little more carefully before you take the remarks of some vindictive young girl so seriously. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Good. All right, Jack, thanks.
I still think she has information, Gov. We've heard from unconnected sources that there's something seriously iffy going on to do with the licensing of massage parlours. And her dad is on the Health and Safety Committee.
Yeah, well, I think Saudi can afford one more day.
Gov.
Oh, well, Danny, try using a pinch of diplomacy this time, all right?
Can you believe Mr. Brownlow?
Well, he might be right.
About Jessie? Come on, you don't really believe that.
Well, at least now she's away from her parents, we might be able to find out. We could always pay a visit to Bryony's squat in Asham Street.
So you do think there's something in it? Yeah, what are you lucky? Jesus! What's happening?
Bastard! You can go to hell!
You know Jessie, do you? We're arresting her and a friend for possession.
Is there any particular reason why you've raided the squat right now, sir?
We received information that drugs were being dealt from the premises. Why?
Can I ask where the information came from?
One of Mr. Brownlow's contacts on the Drugs Initiative programme.
Thank you, sir. Just curiosity.
Right. Come on, let's get them down to the station.
Brownlow. His mate Cooper put him up to it.
Look, it's not going to do Cooper's reputation much good, is it? Daughter nicked for possession.
If he knows journalists are already on his case, it's going to be better to shock the daughter and get in first than wait for the tabloids to do the business on him. Damage limitation. No special treatment for my child, no one's above the law, all that rubbish. Wouldn't be the first time, would it?
She's never going to trust us now. We've been shafted.
Come in.
Jessie's been arrested, sir.
And?
It's down to Mr. Brownlow. He told Mr. Monroe he'd had a tip-off that drugs were being dealt from the squat where Jesse's staying. I think it was Cooper who tipped him off.
Cooper? Why?
Damage limitation. He wanted to be the one to expose his daughter's drug-taking, take the wind out of the tabloid sails.
Politicians.
Yeah, well, now Jessie blames me and she's not going to talk to us.
You don't seem to have taken on board what I said, Danny. You got some kind of problem?
It's my belief that Colin Cooper is involved in some kind of corrupt relationship with Stephen Trent.
I don't believe I'm hearing this. Colin Cooper has been a conscientious councillor for the last 10 years. He's been involved in youth projects, anti-drug campaigns, and he's raised a considerable amount of money for charity.
With respect, sir, some villains, some even well-to-do, go to charity functions to launder their reputations
Danny.
In as public a way as possible, sir.
Unless you've got very hard evidence that a crime has been committed, there will be no investigation. I imagine you've all got much more pressing matters to deal with. You understand?
Good. Did Mr. Brownlow just order me to drop the investigation?
Corruption is notoriously difficult to prove, Danny. So what's this?
Mr. Brownlow and councillors Cooper and Snape, as in recently deceased? At the same charity function as Stephen Trent. Stephen Trent, who owns the string of massage parlours.
It's a coincidence. And you should be careful about what I think you were suggesting.
I don't like it any more than you do, Danny. But it's a lack of evidence that's our problem, nothing else. Oh, come on. You really think Brownlow's being deliberately obstructed?
You don't think he's protecting his mates? It's not just that. What about Jessie? She's crying out for help, and what do her parents do? Drive her out and shop her to the police.
She's not entirely blameless in this, Danny.
It's his own stepdaughter. Unforgivable.
Hello there. Oh, well, they told me down at the station that you might be in here.
Pint.
How's the investigation going?
There is no investigation.
really. Well, I've been talking to a female councillor, right, that she's been trying to get Cooper to withdraw licences from certain massage parlours for years. And she says they're obviously brothels. But Councillor Cooper told her they need a successful police prosecution before they can withdraw licences. She feels that your lot aren't targeting the massage parlours enough.
Well, that's original.
Well, why do you suppose that is? Oh, lack of funding, that old chestnut. And now you've stopped making inquiries. I wonder why.
You're not the only one.
Well, it's a shame if they all get away with it. Still, their type generally do, don't they?
You might want to check whether Councillor Cooper's Masonic Lodge is the same as a certain chief superintendent not a million miles from here.
Are you saying it's Brownlow who put a halt to the inquiry?
You didn't hear it from me.
Please tell me you haven't just done something really, really stupid.
Like what?
There'll be a writ on the editor's desk by midday. A police source close to the investigation. Got any idea who that could be? Nice work, Danny.
Chief Superintendent Charles Brownlow, the senior police officer with responsibility for deciding which licence applications are supported by the police, is in the same Masonic Lodge as the senior counsel on the Health and Safety Committee. Yeah, check this bit. The owner of the string of massage parlours is also a mason.
Oh, that's great, isn't it?
This has got nothing to do with me, all right?
I didn't say it did.
So you've seen the paper, then?
Look, I told him it was off the record. I didn't expect him to start talking about police sources.
Do you know, I wouldn't care if it was just your own career going down the pan, but you've implicated me as well.
Mr. Brown, I'd like to see you too. Now, it's not inconvenient.
Well, if it wasn't you, who the hell gave him the information? Who knew about it?
With respect, sir, the press are renowned for using the phrase sources close to. It's the oldest trick in the book.
Don't lecture me, Kerry.
Sir.
Are you telling me this source doesn't exist? Not that I ever ordered the inquiry to be stopped.
No, sir.
So, our inquiry's still ongoing then, sir?
If the libel action does go to court, it won't do your case any harm if the inquiry is seen to be continuing, will it?
Thanks, Jack. Thank you.
We haven't got any more evidence today than we had yesterday. And we didn't have any then.
Jessie's been in touch. She realised I was behind the article. She wants to meet up. So it wasn't such a stupid idea after all.
And you don't think the caution might have something to do with that?
What caution?
Bryony got charged with possession. Jessie got away with a caution. Didn't you know? After you.
I got it.
Oh, this is for you, Danny. A journalist called Someone's French. She's calling back.
I've got nothing to say to you.
Oh, why?
Said it already, have you? So the brand I have to say.
Right.
Or was it just a social chat?
Really?
You
sure?
You ready?
And there's no other explanation you can think of? No, right. Yeah. Okay, thanks. That was a scene examiner on the hotel suicide. Do you remember that whiskey bottle that was in Snape's room? There were no fingerprints on it. Looks like somebody's wiped it clean.
You think there's anything in it?
No. Oh. It's got to be worth pursuing, isn't it?
In the circumstances, I think it'd be best if we give a joint press conference, show solidarity, really have a go at the press.
Take a seat, Colin.
You have a problem with that?
No. No, I can understand your reasoning. Absolutely. It's just for purposes of clarity and in terms of our professional remit. I think we should be seen as entirely separate entities. We should conduct the press conferences, but independently.
Listen, thanks for, you know, putting a word in yesterday about the blow. Caution.
Yeah, well, forget it. Just tell us what you've got.
It's all got to be off the record, right? But if my mum finds out I've done this to Colin, she'll never forgive me. Really, she'd disown me. I know she's crazy, but I don't want to lose her.
We're not going to force you to testify if you don't want to, Jessie. Just tell us what you know.
All right. My stepdad's got this villa in Spain that was paid for by a guy called Stephen Trent. He owns a load of massage parlours.
Go on.
He gets my stepdad to license his clubs and stuff. Turn down applications for other people.
How do you know this, Jessie?
How do I know? Because we go there on our holidays. He makes out he rents it, but I know he doesn't. It's his. Payment for what he's done for Stephen Trent. You can check it out if you like. He owns it, that's the address.
What about Mr. Brownlow?
I was wrong about him.
What do you mean you were wrong?
He's mates with my stepdad, but he's not bent.
So why did you say he was?
I'm sorry, all right? I don't know why I said it. I was just... I thought he might be, but he isn't.
Do you know for definite that he's not involved?
Yes.
How do you know?
In Spain, when Trent came round, I used to listen in on their conversations when they thought I was asleep. I heard loads of dodgy stuff. And I told my mum, but it didn't matter what I said. She didn't want to hear.
Jessie, just tell us about Mr. Brownlow.
About a year ago, Trent wanted my stepdad to get Mr. Brownlow to put pressure on some other massage parlour called the Blue Dream. He wanted to get it put out of business, raided, whatever. Thought they could get Mr. Brownlow to sort it. Anyway, my stepdad had to admit he didn't have any sway over Mr. Brownlow. Trent wasn't pleased, but he accepted it.
So why were you telling us yesterday that Mr. Brownlow was corrupt? After all, you've known for over a year that he wasn't. Or were you just trying to cause trouble?
No. Look, just check the villa, see who owns it, and then ask yourselves how he could afford it.
You don't seem too happy about Brownlow not being bent.
Not all corruption is overt, you know. Brownlow gave Cooper the benefit of the doubt because they're in the same cosy little club and he didn't give Jessie a chance.
Well, I can't say I blame him.
Well, you should. He may still be involved. We don't know for sure that he isn't.
Oh, you just don't give up, do you? Thank you. Muchas gracias. Okay, right, Cooper does own the villa, but get this, the agent remembered something unusual about the deal. He paid for it with cash.
Well, well, well.
Hey.
In cash?
Well, he could have a reasonable explanation.
Like what? I want all the stops put out on this one, and no more leaks to the press. I'll have a conference when I'm good and ready. What the hell I'm going to say, I don't know.
Sir? For what it's worth, Jessie said she knows you're not involved with any of this.
How would she know that?
It seems she heard Trent asking Cooper to get you to authorise a raid on a rival massage parlour, the Blue Dream, in order to get it closed down. Cooper said he didn't have any sway over you.
Well, make sure you get that in her statement.
It's off the record, sir.
Oh, no, it's not. She testifies. You make sure she does.
Sir, Cooper's her stepfather. Her mum will never speak to her again.
Danny, we're dealing with a serious case of local corruption. We need all the evidence we can get.
But we know what we're looking for, sir. There's a good chance that we'll get other witnesses.
And then there's the matter of Snape's death. I mean, there might be something in that.
I thought there was a suicide note.
There was. But the whiskey bottle that was in Snape's room was wiped clean.
Well, until you get something a little more tangible, we'll go with Jessie's evidence.
I'm not sure I'll be able to persuade us.
Well, you'll just have to try very hard, won't you? All right, thank you. Jack. Get it sorted, will you?
Okay.
I can't believe that. When Jessie can help him save his reputation, he suddenly takes her seriously. And he doesn't care what she has to go through to testify.
Danny, a word in my office. Mr. Brownlow's had a bit of news. The paper's lawyers have told him they've got the police source on tape. Now, apparently, the officer involved is clearly heard on tape explaining that Mr. Brownlow is part of the same Masonic lodge as Mr. Cooper, and that is why he ordered the investigation to be dropped. Now, if I was the officer concerned,
I'll be hoping that Jesse testifies. Because the only way the paper are going to back down and keep his name out of court is if there's solid evidence that Mr. Brownlow is not involved. And at the moment, they're only going to get that from Jesse.
You okay?
Yeah. You better go and see Jesse.
Anything wrong?
Nothing's wrong.
So we're going to persuade Jesse to testify, aren't we?
You come in.
You promised you wouldn't make me testify. Don't ask me to do this. Please, Danny.
You know, your mum might just thank you one day for showing her just what kind of man Colin Cooper is. But we need your evidence to prove it in court. You want him to get away with all this? Is that what you want?
I'll just go in and get my stuff before we leave. I'll give you your statement.
You're doing the right thing, Jesse.
Do you really think her mum will thank her? Or is it just that you're suddenly as keen as Brownlow to get this libel case settled out of court? Don't you think you're being just a bit hypocritical, Danny? I'll wait for you in the car.
Well, it's all there. You've done an excellent job. Well done.
Thank you, sir. If that's all.
No, not quite. You were right about Colin Cooper and I was wrong. I owe you an apology. That's it.
Sir.
Mr. Brownlow, pleased?
Coffee?
Just hope Jesse's gonna be all right.
I was told to get a statement. What else was I supposed to do?
You tell me. You haven't exactly been short on opinions lately.
Look, Brownlow's just apologised. He admitted he was wrong.
Oh. Well, it's nice to know that some people can.
We're going to arrest Cooper and Trent at 8 o'clock. Now, those of you on Kerry's team will be hitting the council offices at about the same time. You got the warrant?
Yes, Gov.
And you'll be impounding the relevant documentation for the OCG team. But at this moment in time, the most important thing are witnesses. We need corroboration for what we've got. So a couple of council whistleblowers wouldn't go amiss. Kerry's also going to be checking out the links between Councillor Snape's death and the corruption.
Are we likely to find any whistleblowers?
Well, the word is there's at least one employee who's seriously unhappy about what's been going on. There'll be more.
Now, this operation is going to take a lot of tact, because we're dealing with people's careers here. Now, I know it's not every day we get to nick a bent councillor, but let's make sure the procedure's spot on.
What's going on?
Hi, I'm DC Holmes. Do you work here?
Yes, I do. What's happening?
The Health and Safety Department.
You took your time.
Right, sign there, please, sir.
I think I'm entitled to know who has made these allegations against me. I'm not entirely clear what the allegations are. Charles, what the hell is going on?
You've got some questions to answer, unfortunately.
Right this way, please, Mr. Cooper.
Don't worry, Colin. The solicitor's on his way. Charles?
Jack? Danny? Quick word.
Mr. Stephen Trent.
Well, I think there's a good chance that Cooper will give us what we need, but I'm not sure about Trent.
Cooper's no fool, Jack. I'll make sure it's water time.
Ah, thanks.
I thought you might like to know that thanks to Jesse's statement, the newspaper has withdrawn the allegations, so it won't be going to court. The identity of the police source won't be revealed. Which is probably just as well, isn't it? All right, keep me in touch.
Well, it looks so miserable. You just got your career back. You should count yourself lucky. Kerry, how's it going?
Oh, Gov, I think I might have found a council whistleblower.
Tremendous.
So, Susan Perry says she's given the committee evidence on 6 separate occasions about Trent's massage parlours being brothels, apart from a couple of genuine ones that he uses to keep up appearances. But he's never had a single application turned down.
And she's pointing the finger at Snape and Cooper?
Well, Cooper in particular, but they both voted in favour of Trent. Now, at the moment, this is strictly off the record, but the way things are going, I think she'll make a statement.
Good work, Kerry.
Sorry to interrupt, Gov. Couple of messages for Danny and Kerry.
OK, well, I'll leave you to it.
Gov.
There's a Miss Sullivan at the front desk. She's a receptionist from the hotel. Also, Dave Quinlan phoned from Casualty St. Hughes. Your witness is down there.
Looks like intimidation. Passerby saw the assault and called us, but by the time we got there, the attacker had gone.
With a cut on her face?
Well, they say it's not been a scar, but she's still pretty shaken. She says it was a warning, and she's healing it. She's decided not to give evidence.
Get out of my way. You've got my daughter in here, Jessie Brown.
Yes, this way.
Where is she?
I'm sorry. She must have discharged herself.
She's gone.
None of this would have happened if you hadn't persuaded her.
OK, hang on a second, Mrs. Cooper. What sort of state is she in? Is she all right to be walking around out there?
What do you think? She's in shock and terrified.
Mrs. Cooper.
You've got a nerve. I finally get my life sorted. Find a man who treats me well, doesn't go chasing after other women, has a bit of money, and then you turn up with your nasty innuendos and lean on a teenager.
We need to find Jessie. If there's anywhere you think she might be.
Jessie's done a runner.
My little girl. Scarred for life, probably, and it's all down to you. Are you happy now?
I think you really know who's responsible for what happened.
None of this would have happened if you hadn't pushed her into making that stupid statement, and you know that.
It's not your fault.
My fault? What are you talking about, my fault? If this is your attempt at the caring colleague bit, forget it, all right?
Fine.
All right, hang on. Kerry, I'm sorry. The trouble is, it is my fault. I should have organised witness protection.
Well, I don't know whether she would have got it. There weren't any threats before this, were there? Now, come on, we just have to stay focused on Trent. He's the cause of all this.
I get it. The case against him just went down the pan.
You don't know that!
Oh, really? Jessie's evidence is history. Your counsel witness was only going to testify because Jessie was. You think she's really likely to testify now? If she's the only witness. Exactly. Old case is shot. All I've managed to achieve is Brownlow walking away with a nice, big, fat out-of-court settlement. What did the receptionist at the hotel have to say?
Not a lot. She reckons she saw a man leave the hotel late that night carrying a bouquet of flowers, and she thinks she may have seen him take them in earlier.
And that's it? Nothing to link it to Snape?
She couldn't even remember this person's face.
Oh, great. I understand your main witness is withdrawing her evidence.
Where'd you hear that?
Oh, word on the street. If you can't produce any evidence against my clients, their continued custody could be seen as unlawful imprisonment.
Sarge, I want to interview Mr. Cooper. Could I have a quick word with Mr. Trent first? Just want to put me in the picture about what's happening. Sarge, any chance so you could get Cooper out? I'll be doing this, eh?
You behave yourself.
Any harm comes to Jessie, and I'll tear you apart.
All right?
Yeah. Jessie, your stepdaughter's been beaten and threatened. I wondered what you could tell me about that. You don't seem surprised.
It had nothing to do with me.
But if she decides not to testify because of it, you're not going to complain, are you? Just how far will you be prepared to let it go? Your own stepdaughter.
My client's already told you he knows nothing about it. So, if we could move on.
If anything happens to Jessie, you're not going to be able to wash your hands of it, Councillor. Oh, you can try. But you'll be just as responsible as the person that lays into her with a baseball bat or broken glass.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You're a liar.
You know, we're getting nowhere here. I suggest you answer no more questions.
Right, you've got a couple of hours. If you don't get anything, they walk.
I don't know where the hell we're going. You got any ideas? We're not going to find it. They've done it. They've stuffed us.
What about the journalist?
What about him? The scumbag's neck needs ringing.
Yeah, we'll just hold fire on that. We've got nothing else to go on.
I would never have given up the tape. No, it's the editor bluffing. I don't divulge sources.
So you did record our conversation.
You've got to cover yourself.
Is that what you call it?
Danny. Look, the point is, we're all after the same thing. And at the moment, we're stuck. So if you've got anything that you want to tell us, I mean, maybe about your anonymous tip-off, for instance, it could be really helpful.
What have you got for me?
If we get a result, you get the story. You're first to know.
All right, but it's not much and I'm going nowhere with it either. And there's my chat with Councillor Snape before he so tragically fell from the window. Otherwise, I'm just hitting brick walls.
You talked to Snape in the hotel?
Yeah.
The night he died?
No, it was a couple of days before that. He had something on his mind. He got very anxious.
What did he talk about?
Well, his wife mainly, how he'd been a fool. He'd got mixed up with some woman who worked in a massage parlour. Yeah, that's exactly what I thought. You get him pissed one night, you set him up with a tart, you take a few pictures, and suddenly you've got no problem getting your massage parlours licensed. Then he confessed his infidelity to his wife, she chucked him out. They no longer had a hold over him.
Did Snape say anything about Trent?
No, he didn't. But he wanted to, I'm sure of it. He was getting seriously frayed at the edges.
Enough for Trent to want to get rid of him before he cracked.
Yeah, crossed my mind. But then he left a suicide note, didn't he? So maybe he just thought it was all coming out and he just couldn't face it. You want to talk to your witness at the council? I'm sure she had her suspicions.
Look, I don't want to be seen talking to you, I've told you.
Well, it's either here or in there. Okay. So what can you tell me about Snape and Trent? Did they have any contact in the days before Snape died?
Snape and Trent? I never saw them together. It was Mr. Cooper who saw Trent.
Well, what about Snape's moods in the last couple of days?
He was depressed, anxious. Mr. Cooper didn't help. He was angry with him. You could see it. I don't know what about, but Mr. Snape was near breaking point. Look, I've got to go back. I don't know anything else.
All right, thanks.
That's all?
Yeah, I'll call you.
Do you think it could have been Cooper who was in the hotel room?
I think I want another look at that suicide note.
It couldn't have been forged.
What if this suicide note wasn't a suicide note? What if it was a note that Snape wrote to his wife to go with, I don't know, some flowers to apologise for his behaviour? Dear Sarah, please forgive me. I'm really sorry. All my love, Tony. What if it was just the context that made us think that it was a suicide note? Okay, just bear with me. What if Cooper was with Snape that evening? Getting drunk together, giving him advice on how to get back with his wife?
The whiskey bottle.
Exactly. Hey, what if Cooper was the man that the receptionist saw coming into the hotel with a bunch of flowers? He might even have suggested the wording on the note. I mean, they've known each other for years. Okay, so when he had the note, He faked Snape's suicide, took the flowers away, and left the note behind, so it looked like a suicide note. I mean, he wouldn't want to leave the flowers in the hotel room in case we linked them with the note. And it also explains why the receptionist saw the same man coming out of the hotel later that night carrying the same bunch of flowers.
All right, let's just go with this for the moment. How do we put him at the scene?
With difficulty. He wiped his prints off the bottle, and it looks like he's cleaned the room of all evidence.
Witnesses who might have seen him?
Nobody came forward. Hang on. The note. Snape had to have written the note. But as far as I can remember, there was no pen found on his body. And there was no pen found in the hotel room.
Didn't Cooper have a flashy pen on him when he was arrested?
About time.
Before we release you, I just need to check something. Hold your arms out for a moment, would you? Just hold your arms out. Did you take top off? Now, that looks to me like the same colour ink that was used in Councillor Snape's suicide note. If that's the same pen, it might still have his fingerprints on it. I don't think we're releasing you quite yet.
If it's got his fingerprints on it, that's a very simple explanation. I lent it to him the other day to write something.
You're still under caution, Mr. Cooper.
I'm just telling you.
Now, would that have been before or after he wrote the suicide note and threw himself out of the hotel window?
Yes.
Oh, there you are. Jessie Brown's turned up at the front desk and she wants to see you.
Wasn't expecting to see you here.
Yeah, well, I decided I wanted to see it through.
Thanks. I should have organised witness protection. Listen, Jessie, there's something I should tell you. It looks like we're going to charge your stepdad with the murder of Councillor Snape.
Murder?
Yeah, I know. It turns out it wasn't suicide. But it means that he's probably going to get life whether you testify or not. But we want to do him and Stephen Trent for the corruption as well. And your evidence will help put Trent behind bars.
Can you do them for the assault on me too?
There's a good chance, yeah.
Maybe now my mum will understand just what sort of a person he is.
So you'll testify?
Yeah.
Murder? Cooper?
Forensics have confirmed the ink was the same used on the note, and they've got a mark off the pen that matches Snape's prints. So that puts Cooper in the room at the time Snape wrote the note.
So it looks as though poor Tony Snape didn't jump, he was pushed.
Well, they were frightened he might lose his nerve, confessed to everything. They had the press on their tails, so he had to go. The case against him is solid. Cooper will get life. And now we've got Jesse back on board, we should be able to do him and Trent for the corruption.
Oh, well done again, Danny.
It's not down to me, sir. It was Kerry made the connection.
Oh, really? Well, well done, both of you.
Looks like Masons are fallible after all, sir.
Right, well, thank you.
You like trouble, you, don't you?
Sorry, Gov, couldn't resist.
Was that a smile?
There is no puzzle you are unable to unravel.
Your mental faculties have returned to their razor-sharp incisiveness.
Must be pretty perspicacious, too.
What?
Why on earth would I claim it'll found £500,000 if I hadn't?
No!
For a greed-driven officer, quite a scam in itself.
You are up to cracking it. Up here.
Exactly £500,000.
The world is mine.